Logan Lawson is a member of the White Mountain Apache Tribe and resides on the Fort Apache Indian Reservation. His career in forestry started back in 1997 as a wildland firefighter with the local SWIFT program. He was hired by the Tribal Forestry Department in 1998 and is still there today, 17 long years later, right? How time goes by. This started when you were like two. He currently serves as the Assistant Tribal Forest Manager and helps oversee the forest development and forest management and protection programs and other tribal forestry day-to-day operations. So please welcome Logan.
A little bit more. That was a quick short bio that I did. TFPA project with the White Mountain Apache Tribe. I wasn't fully involved with this project, but I was there overseeing a different program. But thanks to my supervisor, Mr. Brooks, and this afternoon, say, hey, Logan, look this and present this for me. So just bear with me. I'll try to answer all the questions I can at the tail end of this presentation. But it was a good working relationship so with our partners to the north. It's sad to say that in order for us to have a good working relationship with them, it happened through a fire. Wildland fire that happened in 2002, which was on, I believe, his leg, Gary, the rodeo tennis guy, not Tedeschi, so everybody has a problem with that. Not saying, but it's rodeo tennis guy, and it was in Arizona. And 240 plus thousand of that was in my backyard, west side of the reservation, so. Closed our mill down. I mean, after two to four years after the fire, closed our mill down in the West End. But through that, you know, everybody, I'm pretty sure, heard the news or some people that have been there. I was there from the beginning to the end. It went through Forest Service then, so had to take that wildfire for us to have that working relationship with the Forest Service. So it took that, and you know, from there on, we've just been constantly calling each other up. You know, trying to force you with the Forest Service and TFPA project came around. So. With that, I'm going to begin. Here are some of our partners that we have as a forestry department there in Arizona. Is that, of course, the Forest Service, which is the U.S. Forest Service, who borders our northern side, which is Apache Creek, and then eastern side will be the Apache. Then our west will be Tonto. Then south, of course, is St. Carlos. Then again, we're NRCS also is one of them. We did a lot of projects with them. I mean, they've constantly been there. We've always been working with them. Then of course, you know, BIA, they're there. You know, they're always been there at the get-go. So whenever we have that working relationship with them also constantly throughout the year. Then of course, ITC. Why relationship? Necessary to meet resource objectives, one of the main ones. Especially on shared boundary within landscape and level and issue and concern. Then again, potential source of revenue to commerce objective and job creation. With this Lost Burrows project, that's what we call it. That's what I'm gonna present on. It was a pretty good project, big project we had. Before the Lost Burrows project took place, the tribe got with each other and maybe a tribe and other departments. They talk about this. And this came about, and my boss was there. I wasn't there, no, I was a field manager at the time, but they all got together and put their head together and said, hey, let's do something about this project here. And this is the Apache Sibri Master Force Lost Burrows project. This red arrow is where we had that Lost Burrows project is at. This kind of beige color is our red zombie. That's the Forest Service. So that was exactly where it was. Maybe it bumps right up to our red line, the project that they're proposing. A little bit of background in that. Lost Burrows project was a result, again, of TFPA training session held at Honda. Got ahead of myself there for a bit. It was back in March 2009, and then thereabout, we got the ball rolling and further discussions between us, the White Mountain Apache Tribe, and the AWARS continued after our meeting. And I want to make this clear, and that was key to this project of making work, was communication. We had that constant communication with them all the time. So, like I said, after the Rodeo Tennis Guy fire, you know, to me, that was key. I was involved in a few of this meetings, but the communication that we had with them was, we just constantly communicating, the district ranger and the force supervisor and Jonathan and all my department, we just constantly kept talking. Kind of backtrack a little bit to that road to this guy fire. Really, this project was a success too, was that we did some other side jobs with them already during that road to this guy fire. We created that working relationship. I think it was a fence, boundary fence rebuilding that we did, and that was destroyed during the RC fire. And then we did a lot of snag falling for them on their side and on our side. We did a chain and pulled well more than that. I think two chains. For those of you that don't know, chains is 6 feet is a chain. So we did two chains on both sides of the wrist. So we did some contra falling for them. And Chavo Forchi was the one that did all of that. They didn't go to the DIA, they went to us, and that's where we established that working relationship with them from there on. Let's see if we get this map to show. There's the project map of the Los Burros project. The project has 9.5 miles common boundary between them and us, and then it bordered our 32,500 acres of tribal land previously treated by Dinan and prescribed burn. So we had an investment that we put in already on our side. All of that investment, and we didn't want that to go down here with the fire starter on their side coming over. So they seen it, and they seen the work we've done, and this 32,500 was all within WUI. So the area around Los Burros, the map I showed you earlier, this is the community of McNary, Honda, the whole area. And as you go further west, it's a community of Pine Top, Lakeside, and Shoal. All of that has been treated on our side. I mean, we're talking about 20 plus miles of prescribed burning, of wood treatment we've done already, we've created. I mean, we constantly go in there and burn it, and that's a good mile of treated we did from our red boundary interior. All of that was already protected. It's just on the opposite side of the fence was the one that bothered us more. And obviously it did them, so they approached us with this TFA, so they all started from there. And then again, why Los Burros? Like I mentioned earlier, that we had an investment already, Los Burros project. Then again, it was shovel ready also on their end. I mean, lucky enough, we just happened to meet at Honda all at the same time. They had this project shovel ready, and once they met with us, and we just talked more on it. Not only that, you know, we had our error funds also on our side that we're utilizing after that road to this guy fire. We got one of the biggest grant, I believe it was, and we had folks on board. Our organization was pretty big at that time. And approximately, we treated 5,585 acres of their land. Well, actually, that bordered us, and that was treated. So we did quite a bit on their side. And again, like I said, one of the main reasons why this project was a success was it was already shovel ready on their end. So NEPA was already done. They already were working on it in the previous years. After the RC fire, like I said, in 2002, I believe they had this on their planning phase a year, maybe 2 years after the Rhode Island Sky fire, and they've been working on it. So, because it took them about 2009, it was when all complete and done. So, they had that time frame to get all the NEPA process done in their side. So, we just met at a perfect timing at Honda. So, to talk about this. Then again, like I said, the tribal land borders and Forest Service and had not been treated in the past 2 decades. There was their side of the fence. I might have some photos here, I'm not too sure, but it'll show aerial photos. I might have that at the end, but it shows you can definitely see on our side and then on the Forest Service side, like in the previous discussion they had earlier. So, preparation. Again, like I said, all came about from our meeting at Honda, and then we proceeded on with the Los Burros project, and our tribal chairman, Ronnie Lupi, was very supportive of this. He got him on board. Jonathan briefed him, you know, and then I briefed him in my own language. So that was key. You know, we got him to understand, and he supported it, and we went on with this project. And the force supervisor accepted, and you know, the reason the force This Corbin Newman in July 2009 said everything was a go and back in July. And then, of course, our manager, Jonathan Brooks, and a Lakeside District Ranger, Ed Collin, prepared and participated in agreement with air funding and Lost Birds Project. So that's where I said that air funding was came into place. We had funds already, and they worked out a deal to where that co-mingle fund, we're going to use that fund. You know, they got all that lined out with Ed. That agreement was prepared and approved in September, a couple months down from July. So everything was a go. They had that in place. You know, they took them quite a while, but they had some kinks in there. And once that was prepared and ready, so this project was going to take off here. Then we had it in three tasks. Our first phase was preparation, treatment of areas, timber marking and cruising. And one more thing about this is from the beginning of phase one all the way to the very end, the White Mountain Apache Tribe Forgery were involved heavily from the pre-planning, the layout, everything. We had guys go out there. Some of them, we had some guys that were previously in the timber sale that we hired that's been with the forgery, so they had knowledge in that. So we set them out there. We had a five or four man crew that had knowledge in this. So they laid out everything for the Forest Service with their help. Obviously, you know, we did all of that and we were involved from the beginning in phase one. Phase two was a pre-commercial thing. Then again, we did that as a tribe. We hired, like I said, we had folks and we got them on, and I think it was a 12-man crew. Then phase three, the final phase, after all of this done, was the prescribed burning. Then again, which we were involved in that also. So that came in handy where we had one of our prescribed fire boss trainee individual got signed up through this project. So he just needed a few more, but one more signature to get signed. But the key to this was we were involved heavily from the beginning, which is what made this key, which made this project a success. So from the beginning, from the planning, or from the meeting, all the way to the end, we're involved heavily with it. Again, involving tribal resource was key, like I was saying earlier. So from the beginning, we had to form a tribal timber preparation crew, like I was saying, to give crews and its leadership training and experience to become standalone timber prep crew for a future project, which we had training and they were certified. Now, there's a couple of them that we got certified in this. In our training, like the training was the main thing. You know, it was anywhere from using GPS, marking waypoint, you know, downloading all the data they did, timber marking, and tree measurement, you know, cruising data, everything that requires in prepping a block. We were involved and we had our guys involved in that very heavily. And it was a success, I tell you that. I was there a couple of times when they were doing that. I mean, we had guys, we had an intern, one college intern, came out of Fort from NAU, we brought her on, and she enjoyed every bit of it. She walked away with a lot of training after this. I mean, it was a success. Cross training, of course. Here are a few pictures of timber marking they did and some prescribed burning that took in place. Then again, I cannot stress enough to where we were involved heavily from the beginning all the way to the end, which was good. Then some of the pre-commercial thinning that was done, and this mechanical picture you see in here, Forest Service used that also, kind of more interior away from the barn, but the rest was that 1,500 plus acres was all cut with crews, done with crews. It was all done with hand crews that we hired. I just threw that picture in there to where they did some mechanical thing in the Forest Service side. Like I was saying, one person, tribal crew, was employed to complete the work. So with that crew that was hired, of course we had some up and downs. You know, we had, like I said, we had the Aero funds, we had our project, we had to meet on that side. Also at the same time, we had this TFA project, so we were kind of, they're flexible with scheduling. You know, 3 days out of the week, they may be over here doing this. Then the last 2 days, we have them doing air funds. But all in all, this project was complete. You know, we finished it, and it was a success. Then again, the accomplishment. You know, several tribal employees were trained in tree measurements, and we got five that were certified out of the seven. So that's a big accomplishment, I think. And those five that were certified, we still have two employees And the other three moved on with their certification, got job with the BIA forestry. And hopefully we'll get them back here, but it was through this project where they got the experience and got certified and just opened doors for them. And then we had two crew leaders that were trained in advanced cruising design. Those are the two that I was talking about that we still have. And again, a total of 5,000 plus 500 acres was treated, marked and cruised for them. And over 1,800 acres of that was pre-commercial slash treatment that we've done. Again, the project was successful. Was it was jointly prepared by Travel and Forest Service. NEPA was ready. Main thing, they had the project shovel ready. We just happened to meet at the same time, and they needed our help, I guess, to implement it. We approached them. And again, the funding source, like I said, we had ERA, so we had that project. So Jonathan and the district ranger met, and they came up with the agreement. And little turnover occurred, the Forest Service Tribal Forestry leadership also. Continue on with that, you know, and mutual respect for the tribal and Forest Service employees led to a strong willingness to complete the project despite the number of delays. Much needed thinning and restoration work was completed adjacent to the reservation boundary near the community of Pinetop Lakeside. And again, there was Honda Engineering and again, wildlife benefit from the improvement habitat. Like I said, they had an area that was never treated. Ever. So our side was done and said we did our part, it was just doing their part, which with this Lost Birds project was a huge success. And because of this project was so successful, we had a meeting about a month ago at the TFA workshop. Jim did in Albuquerque. We have another TFA project that we're proposing again to do, and it's even a bigger one next to this. So our future in TFA looks bright. Not only that, but we have another project that I'm approaching the Tonto or further west end of the reservation that we might be able to do also. So, I mean, our future looks good there with TFPA. This was a huge success for us. So, then again, that one I'm talking about is coming up is with the Forest Service. And we already communicated with the district ranger, and talks have been done already. And I don't think we have a problem. We won't have a problem going into that again, you know, agreement with them again. So, it's just a matter of they're in their final stage of NEPA right now, that project. So if everything goes well, I think by the end of July, we'll have our second TFPA project in the works with the Forest Service, which is good, you know. And again, the picture I was talking about, this was before we did the project. I don't have an after aerial photo, but this is how it looked. Of course, the south bottom end is our risk. That line is a red boundary with that fence line. Wow. And their side was cool. This is the Forest Service. And this is within our Lost Birds project. And I wish I had it before and after, but now it looks like this. It looks good. So yeah. After we went in there and did the project, this was before. We're not our side, so we did their side, and it was a huge success. I mean, again, I cannot, you know, emphasize communication was key. That was the main thing with this project to get going. The communication we had with the Forest Service. You know, we were constantly communicating on a daily basis with them. And that made it go easier, I think. But like I said, it took a catastrophic wildfire to get that communication going with them. Which, you know, sad to say, I wish that had never happened, but that was a way of us communicating with them and them with us. So had to take a wildfire. But with that, that was our success. And thank you.